These windy, cold days, they're really quite exhilarating, aren't they? Even though they're freezing. I mean, I just love being down here by these rocks, looking at the waves crashing against them and all that stuff. And because I'm a photographer, I want to take some pictures of them. Now, I say this often, but you can't just snap an image and expect it to have an edge. You have to assemble it using the fundamental building blocks of aperture, shutter speed, etc. What do I mean by that? Well, the place you'd begin is to choose what your picture is going to look like. So I would begin by setting the focal length that I want for the shot that I'm going to take, because by changing the focal length, you're going to change how it's going to appear. The next question is, which aperture am I going to use? Because the aperture controls how much is sharp front to back in the picture. Do I want a shallow depth of field as in a portrait, or do I want lots of depth of field as in a landscape? Once I've chosen the aperture, that then, from there, I can then work out which shutter speed I need to get the correct exposure. But you can't always get the shutter speed that you want, because there may be not enough light or there may be too much light for you to use to get that shot. And this is where your ISO comes in. It's the third ball in the juggling of exposure. We've already made a film about manual exposure in which I show you how to juggle your shutter speed and your aperture together. But if you're going to juggle beautifully, you need three balls to do it, and ISO is that ball. Let me show you what I mean by the effect that ISO can have on your shutter speed and aperture. I'm going to pop my camera on a tripod, just so that I know it's in one place and it's not moving, and I'm going to show you what goes on in the back in the little LCD screen. Right, let's switch it on. That's a good place to start. Right, I'm just pointing the camera down here at these rocks. It really doesn't matter. I just want something. So the camera's not moving, so it isn't going to be picking up light from different places. If I set a manual exposure, I've already got a middle of the road aperture of f11. If I'm going to set an exposure for that, I have to change my shutter speed. And in this light at f11, at 200 ISO, that's the finest grain ISO, there's an ISO film. I'm not going to explain what ISO is too much. Go and watch the ISO film. There's a link below. I just want to show you practical uses here. So to get the correct exposure at f11, the light meter's in the middle, I have to use a sixth of a second. That's a very, very slow shutter speed. To our eyes, it looks fairly bright, but that's because our pupils dilate. There's not much light around here. If I want to increase that shutter speed, I can increase the sensitivity of the camera by increasing the ISO. Let's do it. We're currently on 200 ISO. If I jack that up, if I double it to 400, now if you look at the light meter, it says that I'm one stop overexposed. What does that mean? It means I can speed up my shutter speed. If I want to go further, I can increase the ISO some more. Let's go to 800 ISO, and again, it's a stop overexposed, so I can push it higher. I've now gone to a 25th of a second, but I'm still using the same aperture. Let's just put it back where it was. I think it was a sixth, wasn't it? Put the ISO back to 200, because I almost want to show you the effect it will have on a shutter speed. There we go, 6th of a second, f11, correct exposure, light meter in the middle. Let's say I increase the ISO again. Let's take that up to 400. Let's go all the way to 800. You don't need to see it all twice. Now my light meter is saying it's two stops overexposed. That's because I've made the sensor twice as sensitive. So what I've got to do is to cut down some light. Therefore, I can decrease my aperture. So if I make the aperture smaller, from f11, I've gone down to f22, sixth of a second, light meters in the middle. This is the effect your ISO will have on your shutter speed and aperture. Let's have a look at some ways to put that to practical use.